Hello and welcome to After Before Friday, week number 55. This week I'm post-processing an image of the exterior of a Broadway theater in which the highlights are overexposed and the shadows underexposed. Clearly a dynamic range issue. I'm processing it totally in Lightroom, relying on camera profiles, basic adjustments, filters, and the new filter brush. As an aside, if you have an opportunity to see Something Rotten with this original cast, do it. Phenomenal, wonderful, incredible Broadway musical. Anyway, with that said, let's get on with the post-processing. So the first thing that I am going to do, well, let me go into the develop module here, and I'm going to come down to lens corrections. This is something that I've now begun automatically doing with all my photos, and when you click it, you'll see the change. Whoops. There we go. And it is reading the profile of my Fuji X100T that is stored in Lightroom, and it just makes a correction for the lens. I also always click remove chromatic aberration, and if I zoom in, I don't see that there's anything else that needs fixing, more fixing than what clicking that tick box did for the photo, so I'm going to leave it there. You see that the buildings are leaning in from the perspective that I have. Oftentimes auto will correct that, but I'll show you in this photo it doesn't work. It removes too much of the image. So I'm going to undo by Command or Control Z, and I'm going to leave it as it is. The next thing that I want to come down to camera calibration, where there are different camera profiles that each camera manufacturer builds into its cameras. And you can try different profiles to see what it will give you. These are the ones from Fuji, and you'll see that they change how the photo looks, and it's good to do this at the beginning because it will affect the choices that you make in the other parts of Lightroom. So ultimately, I decided to do Astia Soft, and you're looking for the one that gives you the most detail, basically, and sometimes it's hard to discern, but as I went through the choices, this was what I liked the best, so this was my starting point. And then I coming into the detail panel, one thing that I've read about Fuji, specifically X-T1, but I'm applying it to the X100T, is that the sharpening can be a little wonky, and one of the recommendations that I ran across was to pump the detail up to 100. I'm going to move it in. And this is just for my camera. It also gives a minimum masking value of 10, but again, by hitting the Option key and sliding the masking slider, it will show you what you are actually sharpening. The black areas will be unsharpened and the white areas will be sharpened. Let me come back out to the fit and I'll do it again. So here at zero, the entire image is being sharpened as I slide it down. If I go all the way over to 100, you see the outlines of the buildings are being sharpened. So I want it somewhere in between. I'm going to leave it not so much in the sky. I'm going to leave it about here. Okay. Now I'm coming up into the basics panel, and at this point I'm going to crank down the highlights, which will bring that incredible detail back into the sky and the soft waning light of this evening, of this day. I'm also going to open the shadows, and we're going to play with this. You'll see what happens here. It really brightens up the picture. So at this point, before I continue with the other sliders, I'm going to decrease the exposure. And I brought it to about here. Now, what's missing here is a good white point. And actually, before I do that, I'm going to boost the clarity because that can sometimes affect where your white point is. So I'm going to increase the clarity a bit. I brought it up to about here. And then I'm going to come into the white point. And I'm going to hold down, again, my Option key. And I'm going to move the slider. And as I move the slider, you'll see the histogram move to the right. You'll also see the clipping indication light up, and you'll see the white point indicated in the view of the picture. So I'm going to leave it about here. And I now have a white point, and you can see the difference. I'll go back to before and after. It brings in the whole tonal range of the image, which is nice. As for the blacks, you can see that there's some clipping going on. Let's see where we are in the blacks. I'm going to hold down the Option key. And right now, I'm going to leave the blacks where they are, right here. Okay, so at this point, I'm going to add some filters. So let's see. I begin with the radio filter. And I'm going to remember to always click on, double click on the effect to zero out all the sliders before you add a filter. You can do it afterwards, but this just saves steps. I'm going to hold my mouse key and I'm going to click and drag. And then I'm going to reposition by holding the left side of my mouse down and dragging. And this is, I want to brighten up the marquee on the photo. So I'm going to come over here and I'm going to use one of my presets. It's called Focal Point. And you'll see these are all the values, increases the exposure, decreases highlights, opens up the shadows, and what have you. And I will show you the before and after of this. This was before, and this is after. So it really, it's subtle, despite all those value changes, but it does bring your eye into the marquee and the St. James billboard. One other filter I want to add, I want to use a gradient filter, and I want to darken up the top of the photo. So I'm going to again, select that filter. I'm going to click and drag and bring it down to about here. And in terms of values, okay, I need to go back and zero out the values. So I click on effect. And then the effect that I want to put into it is a preset called Sky Drama. And you'll see the values here. It's decreased the exposure and the highlights and opened up again the shadows and a host of other values. But what I don't like in the beauty of the new Lightroom Creative Cloud is that I can remove the effect from the portion of the photo that I don't want it in, and that is on the tops of the buildings. So first to do that, let's click down here on Show Selected Mask Overlay, and the red areas indicate where the effect is being applied. Now to remove that effect, I come over and I click on Brush, and then I click and hold my Option key, which will change my cursor to an eraser, and I can change the size by scrolling on my mouse wheel. So here where it's, and then I'm going to roll over. Here where there's not a lot of, you know, where there's big spaces, I'll use a big size, same here. And then as I get down into the smaller areas, I will decrease the size of the brush and make those fine adjustments here. I'm not going to do this incredibly carefully, but you see how this works. And let's come up here. And that last but not least, well, almost. Okay, there we go. Let's get it off here. Okay, then I'm going to click done. And there's, and that's it. Those, how long did that take me? Obviously, it takes me longer when I explain, but just straight out of the barrel, probably 5 minutes to do this. So let me show you the before. Come on down here. Here's the before, and here's the after. So it's almost HDR looking. I could reduce the shadows a bit if I wanted to, but I happen to like seeing the people. Let's see, I'm just showing you what happens if I do that. And that might be a little bit more realistic looking. Anyway, this is the before and the after, and I hope you get an appreciation for how powerful Lightroom is and that it can pull out all this detail and save this photo that really was suffering from the effect of a high dynamic range that the camera didn't capture. So if you have any questions, please let me know in the comments sections. For those watching on YouTube, you can see more of my videos and other before and after photos on my blog, Visual Venturing. Look for After Before Friday Forum. Thanks everyone for watching.